Thank you, Ethan. It was a SWAT standoff that shut down one of Jackson's busiest streets and put several businesses on lockdown. Police say a teen sexually assaulted a woman, robbed a business, and then barricaded himself in a home.
Police have charged 19-year-old Jarvis Durr with armed robbery of a business and rape. 16 WAPT's Meg Pace joins us now live from where it all happened. And Meg, walk us through this. Where did it all start?
Darren, it started at this boutique on the in the Hanging Moss Shopping Center. Police say that 19-year-old walked through this door and then committed two violent crimes.
I have never seen anything like this besides on TV.
Residents in the Hanging Moss Northside Drive area were on edge Thursday after swarms of police and SWAT shut the busy Jackson Street down during a standoff with a suspected armed robber and rapist.
We have not been able to make contact with this suspect.
What happened, Jarvis?
Police say 19-year-old Jarvis Durr, who was armed with a gun, barricaded himself inside this home after robbing charms across the street and raping a woman inside.
Came to me while I was sitting on the porch. He asked me, did we cut hair here? I told him, yeah.
Moments before police say Durr committed those crimes, a barber at the Magic Hair Salon said he spoke with the suspect. The witness asked us not to show his face. He said he was nervous after just coming face to face with the suspect.
He said he'll be back to get a haircut. He shook my hand and he walked away. About 5-6 minutes. Came running back across the street, holding his pants on one side, and ran into that White House over there.
Durr kept police at bay for an hour. Then, around 3, the SWAT team moved in and took him down. Durr was led out of the house and into an armored vehicle.
The SWAT team went in and cleared the house.
No one was inside when Durr decided to use the home as his hiding place, but families gathered on their lawns, watching and waiting for police to get their man.
What if some people or something had been there? You know what I'm saying? It's really scary. I'm gonna have to move out of this neighborhood. My kids come out here and play. What if it had been my house they ran in?
Well, tonight, Durr is behind bars at the Hinds County Detention Center.
What an ordeal. How is that victim doing tonight?
Well, Darren, we were told that she's recovering at a local hospital. Because she's a sexual assault victim, we're not going to release too many details about her. We don't normally do that in that circumstance, but her family did tell us that she is recovering, and they're just thankful that no one else was hurt.
All right, Meg Pace, live for us. Thank you.